I quite often use a third-party Bluetooth bit of kit to listen to music on my phone.
Okay.
And it occurred to me, because I sometimes click on the odd YouTube video when I see them and I want to watch them, that the audio and video is out of sync. So I think I tweeted it, actually, and you mentioned that you might be able to help me out with it. So what's going on with Bluetooth and why are my videos and things out of sync?
So I think we probably need to dial it back a bit and actually think about what we mean to say that video is in sync or if it is out of sync, because actually it's not a straightforward answer. If I'm watching something on my mobile phone and the video is in sync, that is, that say there's a dot appears on the screen and at the same time I hear a bleep. By the time the picture has reached my eyes and the sound has reached my ears, there's going to be a delay between the two because the sound travels slower than the light does, which is what we'd expect. But if I'm watching the same thing on my computer screen or I'm sitting back in the cinema eating my popcorn watching a movie, the distance between the screen and me is bigger, therefore it's going to take longer, therefore the sync difference is going to be greater. So sync is not necessarily mean that they happen exactly at the same time, but they reach us in the way that we perceive them as happening at the same time, which helps a bit because it means that a small amount of difference will not be noticed because we'll just assume the thing is further away or closer to us, and so we can get away with it. What really will cause you problems is if the sound, as is happening now, comes before the picture. That really confuses us. The sound is late compared to the visual is happening now, then that's fine. It just, to a point, you will notice it's too far, but you'll just think the thing is slightly further away than it actually is. Ugh, back to normal. So I've got a pair of Apple AirPods, which I bought just, well, I needed a new pair of headphones with my other one. The Sennheisers had broken, and I thought I'd try them, see what they were like. I wasn't expecting too much, and turns out that musically they're okay. They're open back, so they're not quite as good in a noisy environment, but they sound okay, the music's fine. Yes, it's compressed audio over a Bluetooth link, but generally I enjoy them, I like them. Other Bluetooth headsets are available. So I can just pop them in, they connect to my Mac, and I can start watching a video. And everything's in sync. I think if we got it close enough to my microphone, you probably hear what's happening.
Inside the cockpit of a strike plane, it's as noisy as putting your ear right next to a pneumatic drill, and that's almost at the threshold of pain.
So you can hear it, and the video, there's audio and video pretty much in sync. So there's obviously something that Apple are doing, and I'm sure other manufacturers do, which means that I shall take these out. And the interesting thing is that as soon as I took them out, it flicked it to be running on the video. As soon as I put them back in, it pauses slightly and it sort of catches up and the video audio is back in sync with the video through my headphones. Let's stop that for a second. So we can see something that's going there, and that when it's coming out the speaker of the computer, it's got to adjust things compared to when it's coming through the headphones, it's got to adjust things. Let's think about what we mean by video and audio being in sync, and then we can sort of see how the thing's got to go through the whole chain and how it all ends up working. So if we go for the classic clapperboard, then the way that old films used to be synchronized is that someone would stand in front of the camera and the microphone, clank the clapperboard, and you'd get a snap, which you'd be able to identify on the video frame and the audio frame. In fact, Sean's just done this to synchronize his two cameras with a pen and a piece of paper.
And the problem is they bounce ever so slightly.
So what we'd expect, if that's the video frame, that the audio data for that thing would have the noise such that we get the crack of the thing hitting each other in that frame. If it happened too early, we would hear the audio before we saw the thing, which would look odd. If it happened too late, then it would sound out of sync again, or that the thing should be far, far away. So what we want to happen is that if when we see this frame appear, let's call this at T equals zero, we also want this piece of audio to appear at T zero. So we want them to start appearing, and that's to start playing for the whole duration, which is going to be, what, 20 milliseconds or so for the whole thing. We want 20 milliseconds of audio to play from the same point. So what we want to happen is that the picture to arrive and the sound coming to my ear to arrive at the same time. If they start off at the same time and the audio processing path that the sound takes it takes longer than the time it takes for the light to get me relative to each other, then they're going to sound out of sync. So we somehow need to make sure that this and this happen at the same time. We've got an interesting problem. I mean, we've got an interesting sync issue anyway, in that I have effectively two separate earpieces, and to get the proper stereo effect, the audio has got to be synchronized between the two of them sufficiently close enough that I don't notice any sort of phasing errors, which again, as is demonstrated here now, would sound really weird if you're listening in headphones. Sean is going to kill me for all the sort of audio processing I'm making him doing. So we've got to ensure that I hear the 20 milliseconds of audio for a frame at the same time as my eye sees that frame. So that's what we're trying to make sure, that the eye and the ear get the same data at the same time. If that slips, or even worse, comes before it, then it's going to look odd. Why would we get variations when we're using Bluetooth headsets? Well, we need to think about what's going to happen when we sort of do this, and that we're going to have the audio data here, and so this is going to be a series of zeros and ones and so on to represent that data. There's going to be about, probably for a single frame, about 8,000 or so bytes worth of data. And then when we send that over Bluetooth, the Bluetooth link is compressed. If you look at the packets that are being sent on the AirPods, it's sending at 250 kilobits per second AAC. So the first thing that's going to need to happen, you're going to have the audio data coming, and then you're going to run that through your compressor. So you're going to compress that into AAC. So you're running through that, your AAC compressor. And that's going to take an amount of time. So there's going to be time here. So let's call this X seconds to do that. That's going to then be split up into a series of packets. And so we're going to break them up into chunks, and then we're going to send these over the Bluetooth wireless stack. Now, probably inside this, these are then going to be reassembled at the other end. Probably you're going to have some sort of buffer here. I mean, I would, and they're probably the same again. So just so that you, if there's some sort of packet needs to be resent, it gets lost, you can resend it and you've got time to go on. So there's going to be a buffer which is going to delay things by about 8 D seconds, we'll say there. And then we're going to run that through the decompressor. So we're going to decomp that. And then we'll get the data back, the ones and zeros, which we can send to my ear. So the signal path coming over Bluetooth is quite complicated. Not only have we got delays because of transmitting it, it's going to have to break things into packets, we're going to compress it, decompress it, all of that's going to take time. So we're going to have this sort of processing chain, which is going to delay the audio. And this is probably going to be, well, enough that you would notice it, which is what Sean's experiencing when he's watching YouTube for his cheap thingamajig.
I didn't say it was cheap, just third party. It is cheap.
Yeah. So that's the problem that Sean's getting with his Bluetooth headset, is that he's noticing that delay. So how can we compensate for it? Well, again, if we think about it, what we want to happen is that this audio data happens in the same time section, that also the same time frame that the video is being displayed, that frame of video is happening there. And so if we know exactly how long this route is going to be, then we can sort of delay the video by that amount of time, so that even though the video is going one route and the audio is going a different route, when they actually hit my eyeball and my eardrum, they appear to have come at the same time.
So we delay the video, do we?
So yeah, so you possibly need to delay the video. You may find actually, of course, that the interesting thing is that it may not be as simple as that, because the video and the audio is coming from probably a compressed video stream and a compressed audio stream. It may be that actually your audio is quicker to decompress. So you may find that actually you've got more things coming here, but the thing we want is that at the same point in time here, we want to get the same frame of video and the same frame of audio. So we need to sort of get the video to be decoded and transmitted to the eye as light at the right time, and the audio to be decoded, re-encoded, transmitted over Bluetooth into the ear, buffered possibly to become sound, and it happens at roughly the same time, i.e. within less than probably 10 to 20 milliseconds, you wouldn't notice it in that sort of time frame. So you need some way to sort of track how long each chain is for the two things to happen, and then work out so that we then release them at the same time. So how do we keep these two things in sync? How do we do that? Well, for the things that happens on our computer, we've written the software, we know how fast the computer's running. We've got some idea for how long that will take. And again, we can sort of buffer things and realign them once we know how things, because we've got audio, which is probably labelled to a particular frame. We've got video, which is labelled to a particular frame. We can decompress them and put them into a buffer, and we can align them and then start playing them out. So we can work that bit out. The bit that we don't know, because the time it takes for the light to get there is going to be so small that it's going to be negligible, so we can assume that's zero. The bit we don't know is the processing time for the audio being sent through the Bluetooth chain and getting to the ears. Now, fortunately, the specifications for Bluetooth audio, which is used on the AirPods, is the Advanced Audio Distribution Profile, which runs on top of the Audio Visual Distribution Transport Profile. And inside the AVDTP, the Audio Visual Distribution Transport Profile, there is an ability for the AirPods or any other Bluetooth headset to send back details of the delay incurred by sending the data. So you can send data back saying, okay, this took X milliseconds. And if you know it's taking X milliseconds to process the data, you can then adjust the video and or the audio as necessary so that they suddenly end up back in sync.
This is basically a feedback loop, isn't it?
Yeah, I guess you could call it that, in that the device is telling you what it is, and then we can adjust it to do that, and we can get things to be synchronous. And actually, it's set up so that if it changes for any reason, for example, I move further away or more Bluetooth traffic is in the area, so it's having to resend it more often or buffer it more to get all the data, then it can adjust the delay and things can happen. We can actually see it, because if I start the video playing now, we could hear it, and then put my earphones in, you'll see it pause and then sort of catch everything back to speed and it's back in sync. So it pauses briefly and then suddenly it flicks and everything is back in sync, because it's had to adjust the actual timings of the two signals. And as I take it out again, it carries on playing things. It's actually a lot quicker to go that way than it is to come back in here.
If it is that I bought a cheap pair, where is the fault? Is it in the device, or is it in the phone, or is it, where is that? Because basically I thought, I've got an expensive, nice pair of headphones and I want to keep using them, but I want to use them wirelessly.
Yeah, okay.
Where's the fault?
So it's an interesting question. It's not necessarily that you bought cheap things. I mean, there's lots of places. So for example, it could be that the software hardware combination on your phone isn't bothering to synchronize this. And Apple have said when they've implemented this, they have, and other people have said they have. That's one possibility. It could be that the device you're using isn't returning the right delay, and so it's still actually, it is delaying it, but it's not accurate enough. There's various reasons where it could be. It could just be that they haven't bothered implementing it because they support an earlier version of the profile that didn't have those in. So there's lots of places where it could be. I mean, you could sort of test it. You could try the device on a different source and see whether that has the same problem. You could try it with a different pair of headphones on your phone, see if that has the same problem, and so on. So yeah. It's not necessarily that you bought a cheap device.
So we're seeing certain sites getting slowed down because, well, we don't like what they're doing. And this is the argument that net neutrality advocates would have, which is that it can't be at the whim of a commercial provider, a service provider, to favour some website.
And it does kind of make green, kind of what I was expecting.
Yeah, green.
I mean, I've had this is a bit orangey, but let's just... Let's...